So, welcome at Cessna Home Cockpit. Today is a special video. I'll have some questions by viewers who ask me how I have set up my monitors, and I will try to explain how I did this. So I don't think we are going to fly, but just a tutorial. I hope this works, my first tutorial. Very important for setting up the monitors is that you realize what your position is in relation to the screens. I'm trying to draw how I've set up my screens. I have three screens. I'll show you the drawing. I'm not a very good drawer. And the screens are at an angle of 90 degrees. So this is my screen setup. As you can see, they are at an angle of 90 degrees. You would expect that the angle of the monitors and X-plane would be 90 degrees also. And that is only the case if you are located directly in the center of the screens. I'll make them a little bit more black so you can see them better on this tape. So these are the three screens. When you are at the center of the center point of the screens, there is an angle of 90 degrees to the left and 90 degrees to the right, as you can see in the picture I draw. But in my setup, as you can see, I'm not located at the center of the cockpit, and I'm not in the middle. I'm on the left side, almost behind the screens. So the angle to the left cockpit of the left screen is not 90 degrees. It's far less, and the angle to the right screen is also not 90 degrees. What I did, I measured the position and the angle. This is my eye point, and as you can see, I'm not 90 degrees to the center of the monitor, but I am this angle. And for the left monitor, it's this angle. So when you measure the distances, you can calculate by the tangens, I think it is, or the sinus of the angle, and to determine how big the angle is. In my case, both angles are 60 degrees. So I have configured the displays to the left and to the right at an angle of 60 degrees instead of 90 degrees. That's why they look better than the 90 degrees angle. So that's one aspect. So you have to calculate how on which angle you are located in relation to the monitor. Another point which is very interesting is the field of view. You have to also measure your field of view, and the field of view is also something you can very easily calculate. I have here a drawing of my front screen top down, and the field of view is actually this angle. So to calculate that angle, you have to measure the distances of the screen, the distance from the screen to your eye, if your eye is located here, and then you can calculate how big the field of view is. In my case, it was also 60 degrees. So I have the field of view, the front screen set up at an angle of 0 degrees, and a field of view of 60 degrees. The left screen has another field of view. I will show you that in another drawing. Each side monitor has another field of view, and that's because when you let me explain it by looking through a hole in a wall, for instance. If you are looking through a hole in a wall, let's say this is the wall, and your eye is over here, very close to the hole in the wall, you can see this. You can see almost everything behind the wall, if you want to watch through a peek through a hole in a wall. But if you go further away, down here, with your eye, you see a very narrow part. You can't see anything at all if you go further away from the hole. Now, why am I trying to explain this? That is because the side monitors are windows, are actually holes. So if you are further away from the monitor, the field of view becomes smaller. So the front screen has a 60 degrees field of view, but my left screen, I'm almost I think less than 1 feet away from the screen, has a far bigger field of view than the right screen. And that's how I have set up my screens. What is important is that you have to choose a location, a point where you determine on which place you determine to set up your screens for. I mean, the camera is located in another spot than my eyes, so the camera sees something different than my eyes see, but it's only a small difference. So first you have to determine on which angle the monitors are of the displays are located, and it's only 90 degrees to the left and 90 degrees to the right if you are exactly in the center point of the three monitors. If you are further away, there is an angle, and then you have to determine how you big your field of view is, and also that depends on how far away you are from the monitors. And X-Plane is very great in and a very powerful tool to has powerful tools to set up your display, so that it shouldn't be a problem. So the first step is to determine which angle. Then you set up the field of view, the horizontal view of field of view. You can also set up the vertical field of view. So I hope this makes clear how I've set up my monitors. I'll put my settings in the description, but it only works if your screens are located at the same position as my screens. So if you are, for instance, a cockpit which is a little bit wider or narrower, or the screens are further away from each other, then my settings don't work at all. So you really have to measure out how big your screen is, at what which angle you are located, and then you can, with some calculations, determine exactly which field of view and which angle you should pick. Let's see if we can start the plane. It has been on the runway of the airport all day, so I think the battery is down, but we'll see. I'll put the master switch on, battery on, fuel pump on, prime the engine, and let's see if she starts. Well, that wasn't too bad. Avionics on. At the moment I don't have pilot to ATC running. So we'll skip the ATC for now. Just want you to show how the settings for my monitor are. I did some fine tuning yesterday according to the noise I just showed you. So I'll do a quick flight, just a pattern flight. We are here at Maastricht Aachen. My viewpoint, the monitors line up perfectly, but I have the camera in another location as I have them usually, so could be that in the movie it doesn't look right at all. Also, I got some questions about the GPS, how I build it. Well, the GPS is fully functional. I can adjust almost everything in the GPS as all the buttons work. And what I did was buy a Leo Botnar board, and basically I bought some very cheap switches. I think they costed me about 50 euro cents a piece. And I glued them on an hardboard plate, and I then printed out in a picture of the real Garmin GPS, and I glued that on top of the switches. So now it looks like a real GPS, but it's actually a paper. With printed text on it, and under the paper I've put the switches, so they are fully functional as the real thing. I also put obviously a TFT screen behind it, which I bought from AliExpress, which is about I think 25 euros for the screen, which is not that much money. So this is Leo Botnar board, and oh, I'm too early. See, oil pressure problem. It's all aboard. We don't want to crash. So no flying for me today. Didn't warm up the engine enough. And that's one of the nice parts of a real expansion pack for the Cessna. Just like in real life, if you are too eager to fly, then something can go wrong. You have to do your pre-flight checks and just let the engine get warm. So thanks all for watching. I hope you I could help a little bit with the settings for the monitors. Feel free to ask any questions, and if I can help with calculate some monitors, I'll be happy to help you. Bye bye.